people are told to come here and try and disrupt and agitate. Yeah. They're bad people, but we are so cool and we take care of ourselves. And remember what I said, the safest place on earth is a Trump rally. Yeah. So, carry a lumpy lid. Ford is building a $2.5 billion plant in Mexico. I've been talking about it for 2 years. It's been my big baby. And $2.5 billion, you know what that is? And they're going to make their cars and trucks and parts, and they're going to pour them right into the United States. We get nothing. Now, the other day I'm reading in the Wall Street Journal that they've decided to do more. They're going to do more. It's going to be bigger. They're going to make it bigger. What do we get out of it? We get nothing. Look at this area. Look at the state of Pennsylvania that I love. They're ripping our businesses out. They're taking our heart out. They're taking our jobs out. And we're not going to let them get away with it.
God bless you.
The system is rigged. The voting is rigged. The whole deal is crooked, 100%, almost as crooked Hillary. It's a crooked deal. And that's why you have a case where I go in and win with the vote, and these guys go and they buy delegates, they buy them dinners, they send them to hotels. The whole thing is a sham. And by the way, I don't know if even my enemies in the media agree with me, and lots of changes are being made. With all of that being said, we're winning by a lot. We're kicking ass. So we're going to stop. And when I came down that escalator with Melania, I had two things in mind. Trade, because we make the worst trade deals probably at any time, anywhere.
Love you,
what China has done to our country. We have a trade deficit with China of $505 billion a year. Then you have these stupid people that write magazines. They call them the elite. Oh, really? They're elite? Do you think they have a better plane than I do? These are elite people. These are elite. They call them elite. That means that we're not elite. That means that I'm not elite. I don't know. I don't think anybody is better. Whatever. Do they have better than what we have? You know, I built a company, and I filed all the papers at federal election. I borrowed $1 million, and I built it in. I mean, you hear the stuff I borrowed. My father gave me $250. I wish my father gave me. My father was tough, and he was from Brooklyn, and he built houses in Brooklyn. And I borrowed $1 million, and I built it into a company that's worth more than $10 billion. Some of the greatest assets in the world, great cash flow, very little debt. And I say it not to brag at all. I say it because that's the kind of thinking we need in this country. On a big, fat, ugly bubble. And if it explodes, it's going to be ugly. You think your businesses are doing lousy now? If that bubble explodes, and it's going to happen, unless I'm elected, you're going to do things that are going to be so good. And that's what I do. We got to get down the debt. We're going to do so many things. But the big thing we have to do is we have to take care of our trade. We can't allow China and to have us have a trade deficit of $505 billion. Japan, massive trade deficit. They sell cars. They give us cars. Millions of cars come in. We give them practically nothing. The balance is up here. We send them beef. Okay, what would you rather have, a piece of beef or a car? It's so imbalanced. We have all the cards. Here's the good news. We have the cards. We have the piggy bank. We're not going to have the pity. We're not going to have it for long because the money is being drained out of our system by other countries. And because we have political hacks negotiating deals for us. So that's going to all end. Mexico has a trade. We have a trade deficit with Mexico, $58 billion, and that doesn't include the drugs that pour across the border, which probably, who the hell knows, it's probably. We are going to do things, and when I get up at the debates, and remember this, I've been number one at every single debate. I've been sent to serve. You've been center stage in every debate, sitting all these politicians. I was driving them crazy. And then the debates, if you look at Drudge, who's an amazing guy, if you look at all the polls, the debate polls, right after the debates, every single debate, every single poll, I won, which is nice. I didn't know if I could debate. I never did that. That's all politicians do. They're all talk. They're no action. And our country's going to hell. And we're going to stop it, and we're going to stop it fast. So, when we have a trade deficit with China of $505 billion, billion, not million, billion, that means, you know, not so good, not so good, right? So what happens is this, we have these people, they're in magazines and they write, they're terrible people. They don't know, actually they might not even be. Maybe, you know, they call themselves, I told you, elite. And they write, and they said, oh, this is gonna be a trade war. There's no trade war. When somebody is taking in $505 billion more than we are, let's have a trade. I mean, it's okay, who cares? We can't keep going like this. And here's the story. We will get along better with China than we get along right now. And we'll equalize things. And they won't be doing what they're doing right now. Right now, they have perpetrated the single greatest theft in the history of the world. They have robbed us blind, and so have other nations. China's been the greatest abuser, but so have other nations. So we're going to stop it, and we are going to bring our jobs back, and we're going to keep our jobs here. And there's going to be a time in the very near future when Apple computer, don't worry about it. Leave him alone. He's got no voice. I can't hear the guy. He's got no voice. Leave him alone. You know the biggest, the cutest thing? My people, they see somebody's going, oh, nobody can hear him. Then my people go, there he is, and they make a run. Don't worry about it, let him, you can't even hear the guy. Oh, but the police are there already, look at that guy. Policemen, Israel, I love you. Look at these guys. Look at these guys. He's like a rock concert, right? A rock concert. Beautiful, look at you, oh. So, hey, ready? So we can't let this go on. We're not going to let it go on. Now, during one of the debates, a couple of the people that I was debating came up to me, and they said, Donald, you know you can't build a wall. I said, why not? I didn't even know what he was talking about. I said, China built the Great Wall of China 2,000 years ago. It's 13,000 miles long. We can't build a wall that's 1,000. Tell me about it, because I want to tell you, and we have Caterpillar tractors. They didn't quite have them.
USA! 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 USA!
So they came up and they said, we can't build a wall. Now it's 2,000 miles, but we need 1,000 miles of wall. Nothing. It's nothing. I will have the most gorgeous wall you've ever seen. Someday, when I'm gone, they'll name it the Trump Wall, so I'm going to make it so big, so slow. And I love Mexico, and I love the Hispanics, and I'm going to get so many jobs for the Hispanics, for the African Americans, for people that can't get jobs now. And we're going to do great. In Nevada, where I won the state, they did a poll. People leaving, Hispanics. I was number one in the poll, an easy number one, and the news reported it. They said, we don't understand, Donald Trump is number one with Hispanics. I love the Hispanics. I can't help it that the leaders in Mexico and every other country that do business with us, we're like the dumb bully that keeps getting knocked down. We get them out. So then I said Mexico's going to pay for the wall. These same two guys walk up to me. They say, Mexico's never going to pay for the wall. I said, why not? If we're having a trade deficit of $58 billion a year, and the wall's going to cost $10 billion, that's one of the easiest negotiations I've seen. And then they had the former president, Vicente Fox, the former president of Mexico. He's being interviewed by one of the big cable networks, and he said, "We won't pay for the," and then he used the F-bomb. And I said, "Oh, is he in trouble tomorrow? It's going to be headlines." He used the F-bomb on live television, right? He used the F-bomb. And I said, "Can you imagine? Hey, by the way, folks, if I ever use the F-bomb, I think I'd get the electric chair. Do you agree?" Okay. This guy, nobody talks about it. Here's what he said. "We're not going to pay for the you-know-what wall on live television." Okay? And the anger was so unfair. And you know why he was angry? How dare somebody tell them to do something? Because for years, they and every other country has been ripping us off, and they're not used to somebody saying, "Listen, we're building a wall and you're paying for it because you're sending a lot of people over and you're giving us a lot of headaches and you're going to pay for that wall." And that wall is peanuts compared to the kind of money you make. Don't even wait. It's so easy. That's almost as easy as telling Carrier, "You better stay or you got problems, okay? You better stay or you got problems." Remember that. 5 years they've been thinking about, what can we do? Let's give an incentive. Let's give them financing. Let's... No. Just tell them, you leave, you make products, great, come in, tax. You don't have to do anything. It's so simple. But they don't want to do it. They don't want to do it. Because they're stupid. I mean, because they're really stupid. Or corrupt, in a sense. They're corrupt. So here's the story. So Fox said, "No way. There is no way." Now, I actually liked it. Because 2 years ago, he used to say, "There is no way we will allow a wall to be built." He obviously understands that's going to happen. Now he doesn't talk about that. Now he just says, "They're not going to pay for it." Believe me, Mexico's paying for the wall, okay? That's it. A beautiful state, a beautiful area, and it was my first victory. Now I've won 23, 24 states. I'm getting spoiled. I gotta win Pennsylvania. That's right. Pennsylvania. And Chris doesn't even know where Harrisburg is. He doesn't. This guy, he went to New York and they threw him around like a rag doll. I love it. When I watch him come in second to Kasich, I just love it. It's so cool. Oh, look, we're all fooled up back there. I hope you people in the back, are you okay? I mean, I feel badly for the people. They got to hear about 2% of what we've been talking about all night. But look. So, we are going to get all of these things done. You've got to get out and vote. You've really got to put a big... You've got to get your friends... You've got to get everybody. Tuesday, you know, a few days. It's amazing how time flies. It feels like I won New York yesterday. It's already like 3 days. And I'll tell you what, it really does. They really know me well in New York. This is serious. They know me well. What really is nice is the people that really know me. I mean, I'm doing buildings here, I'm doing buildings. I employ lots of people. The people that know the person, when they vote for the person, and you get even 10 points higher than the polls were saying you were going to get, that means they love you. I get 61. People say, "Oh, remember they were all saying, the great Jeffrey Lord can tell you this, but they were all saying, Jeffrey, if he can break 50, it'll be a great victory. Is that right? But breaking 60, nobody, I got 61, more than 61. So here's the story. Here's the story. And almost all of the delegates. Here's the story. You got to go out and vote on Tuesday. Because we have a movement going on. We have a movement that's been on the cover of Time magazine many times over the last number of months. We have a movement that everybody in the world is talking about. We have a movement of millions and millions of people. You know, the Republican Party, not known necessarily as the hottest thing in the world, is now one of the hottest things in the world. It's one of the hottest parties in the world. You know, the Republican Party, 4 years ago, Mitt Romney ran and he choked. You know what happened? No, he choked. He should have won that election. That election was easier than this election, but don't worry, I'll win. But he should have won that election. And John McCain ran, and it was a tough one because of the economy, but John ran, and I backed him, and he lost. Mitt Romney ran, and I backed him, and he lost. And then I said to my wife, you know what? This time, I'm going to do it myself. I'm going to get it done. So important. You're going to remember this night. You're going to remember this night. Beautiful evening. Very nice. Other than I don't like the scenery of empty factories all over the place, okay? But you're going to remember this beautiful evening. More importantly, on Tuesday, you're going to remember going to the voters' booth. You're going to cast the most important vote of your life.
Yeah!
You're going to vote for Trump. Did you ever hear these politicians? I mean, you know, they're just politicians. When they say, please, please, go out and vote, even if you're not voting for me. Vote for my opponent. It's so important as an American exercise for you to go out and vote. I'm not saying that. If you're going to vote for anybody else other than me, do not go out to vote.
Okay? Yeah!
I don't want anybody, but I don't think there's too many people in this room that are... Is there anybody in the room that's going to vote for other than Trump?
No!
Who's going to vote for Trump? We have this movement. It's an incredible movement. I told you about Bill O'Reilly, what he said. I told you about Time Magazine. I told you about everything. It's the hottest thing happening. We're up 70% from 4 years ago. The Democrats are down 35%. In other words, Hillary and Bernie are down 35% from 4 years ago. We're up more than 70% in votes, all right? Now, here's the story. And by the way, this is the hottest event all over the world they're talking about. What's happened to the Republican Party? And then you have these people, the bosses of the party, the establishment, they don't like Trump. And you know, they don't like me because they can't take care of me because I'm not taking their money. I want to bring back our jobs. I want to take care of our military. I want to do what's right for our country.
Yes.
We got to save our country. So here's the story. Great night. You're going to go on Tuesday, you're going to vote. You're going to get all your friends, everybody that can vote. Don't forget, the other side votes, and who the hell knows if they're even allowed to vote. You're going to get every single person you know that can vote and go out of vote. You're going to say it was the most important vote you've ever cast. You're going to look back. You're going to look back in 4 years, in 20 years, in 30 years. You're going to say, that was the greatest vote that I ever cast.
Because
when Donald Trump became President of the United States, our country started winning again. We don't win with our military.
We're gonna win.
We can't beat ISIS. We don't win with our vets. We don't take care of them. We don't win with education. Common Core is a disaster, which, by the way, we're ending and we're bringing education. Yeah. We don't win with health care. And as you know, Obamacare, our premiums are going 25, 35, 45% up. We're not going. It's ended. It's over. We're going to have great health care. We don't win at the borders. We don't win at trade. Here's what's going to happen, folks, and you better get used to it. We're going to start winning again. We're going to win with our military. We're going to knock the hell out of ISIS. We're going to win with our vets. We're going to take care of our vets. We're going to win on the border. We're going to have a real border. We're going to have a great border. We're going to have a border where people come into our country, but they can only come into our country legally. We're going to win with education. We're getting rid of Common Core. We're bringing our education locally. We're going to win with health care. We're going to win with trade. We're going to make the greatest trade deals this country has ever made. And we're going to bring jobs back to Harrisburg and to Pennsylvania and to every other state. Products made in the United States instead of made in China. Believe me. We're going to stop their manipulation of currency. We're going to stop their devaluation of currency. We're going to have products like from Apple starting to be made in our great country again. So we're going to start winning again. We're going to start as of Tuesday. We're going to win so much, folks. Some of you won't be able to take it because you're not used to it. We're going to win at every level. And I have fun with this, and I have to say it. Should I say it? We are going to win, win, win. We're going to win so much, and you're going to say, Mr. President, please, please, sir, we don't want to win so much. It's driving us crazy. And I'm going to say, I'm sorry. We're going to keep winning. We're going to win at every single level.